It's Noelle Foley here with Ringside Collectibles, and we are at San Diego Comic-Con, day one, and it's 2018, and I am here with Kurt Hawkins. How are you?
I am great. How are you?
I'm wonderful. Thank you. How are you enjoying?
The year, the day, it was good.
Just got to make sure I got it going.
Got it.
But how are you enjoying the craziness of Comic-Con?
It's definitely overwhelming, for
yes.
sure. Yeah, it's my first one, so, but very cool. Obviously.
And as a lifelong wrestling figure collector, how does it feel being a part of the Mattel Comic-Con panel? We have a special guest here. Want to come in? Come in.
Hey, guys.
Hey, guys.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm trying to get the rub off me. Yeah,
I was just asking.
Booked in weeks. Okay. You ever win, bro?
No.
I was just asking him a question that both of you guys can answer.
Okay.
So as a lifelong figure collector,
sure.
how does it feel being a part of the Mattel Comic-Con panel?
That's great. Is this work?
It's a privilege.
Is this work or are we here just,
yeah.
it feels like
yeah,
a vacation.
Like, to think that it's our job is kind of ridiculous.
Yeah, we're
it's
here to,
so
to,
cool.
to
yeah.
review and look at and reveal new figures, like, that's a job? That's
yeah, it's pretty ridiculous.
It's insane.
Yeah.
Awesome, right?
Yeah, it's great.
But then again, we are very qualified.
Yes. Elite Squad.
To do so.
Yeah.
Elite Squad.
I'll let you finish your interview. I'll
thanks, bro.
Okay.
I'll
interview you later.
See you guys.
Sound
yeah.
good?
Yeah?
Yeah? Yeah? So anyways, what was some of the first figures you remember having, and are they still important to you?
Oh, yeah, and I still have them. Old school Hasbros and stuff when I was a kid. I remember that. I can't remember LJNs like in the store, but I remember that first set of Hasbros coming out, and that was like a big deal to me. My brother and I collected them, and I still have them to this day. So,
very cool. So your daughter Mackenzie is getting old enough to play with toys now.
Mm-hmm.
How does it feel seeing her play with action figures as a dad?
It's pretty. It just warms my heart. You know,
yeah.
it's like I can just sit there and watch her play forever. It's so cool,
yeah.
and it just. I'm constantly getting her more because I'm just like, all right, well. If I like this, she's got to like it, and
yeah.
I can tell she does, and it's just so cool, and I just want her to have a big collection, too,
yeah.
and, you know, hopefully she enjoys it as she grows older, too.
Oh, yeah. mm-hmm. Do you play along with her?
Somewhat, yeah. I invite her all the female superstars, so she's got a pretty big collection already for a one-year-old.
Oh,
but,
yeah.
And I mean, she plays them, she puts them in places and reorganizes them, and that's, like, her way of playing. I don't think she really understands what
yeah.
a wrestling match is just yet, but it's pretty cool.
So you have a new Elite figure coming out this fall along with a Chase variant. How excited are you about your second figure?
That's like icing on top of the cake, you know. I've been collecting the Elite line since it debuted, you know,
yeah.
2010. To finally be a part of it, it's an honor completely. And then now that these variants, I think it's going to be really fun for collectors to, you know, try to get the differences and stuff. And I guess they're going to find out about it today through, you know, the Mattel's plans for all this stuff. Just makes it even sweeter, you know. It's an honor that I think truly, and this has come from my heart, that the Elites are the greatest wrestling figures ever produced, you know, in the history of the business. So now to be a part of that line forever, you know, that's something
mm-hmm.
nobody could ever take that away from me. So it's an honor.
Yeah. What would your dream Ringside Collectibles exclusive figure be?
Whew. Right now, I think what I really want is a Jeff Jarrett with the neck
yeah.
ensemble outfit, you know, very colorful Jeff Jarrett, 1994-ish Jeff Jarrett,
yeah.
you know, cowboy hat, glasses. That's my dream action figure right now, at the moment.
Yeah. So what other figures do you want to see made besides a Bill McKenna, Riviera Steakhouse accessory jacket?
Ooh, that would be, you know, Zach and I think there should be a Maximum Sweat Bill McKenna because he sweats in real life, so his action figure
yeah.
would have to do it too, right?
He's a sweater.
Yeah, big time. That would be cool. I'm lost now. What's the question?
What figures do you want to see besides that?
Another one on my list is I'm really into Eric Bischoff's podcast right now.
Oh,
I realize he would be a great flashback and Elite. I think that would be cool if possible.
What was your first reaction to seeing your Elite figure?
They showed me at WrestleMania Access and I was stunned. I thought it was
yeah.
so cool. Yeah. I'm just looking forward to, like, you know, all I've had so far is the prototype, so I can't wait for to have the real finished product in my hands.
Okay.
I have my daughter's name tattooed on me now and things like that will be on there. I just think that's, like, so cool.
Yeah, mm-hmm. yeah. What's your favorite Elite figure of all time?
Whew, that's a that's a tough question.
It is a tough one.
Man, I don't know if I could just narrow it down like that.
Or what is your top three, maybe?
Whew, man, I mean, I'd have to. So I have like a man cave set up, and they're literally three giant cases just filled with Mattel Elite figures, and they all face me, so I'm constantly staring at them. But it's impossible to narrow it down. There's been so many awesome.
Top 10?
We could have to like.
Or is that even hard?
It's like a homework assignment. I have to like sit down and really break it down for
maybe
you.
Maybe you'll think about it and you'll get back to me and let me know. Because I'm really curious.
It's almost like unanswerable, but yeah.
It's impossible.
No way.
Well, thank you so much, and I hope you enjoy your Comic-Con.
This is a pretty cool experience, so I'm glad to be here.
Thank you.
Thank you.